I'm a student of wisdom and leadership. And one of my favorite areas of study is how the principled man can overcome the unprincipled man. In the last few years, a new question has come to the forefront of my research, ironically. And what is this question? The question is that what role do shrewdness and deception have in great leadership? Let me attempt to answer this by taking the spotlight on rewards and sanctions, carrots and sticks, the two engines which leaders use to execute their will. And let us begin with understanding a term called cobra effect. Cobra effect is a term which is borrowed from colonial India, British colonial India, when the British were really concerned about the number of cobras in Delhi. So the government came out with an offer that it would give a bounty for every dead cobra. This scheme was successful in the beginning. However, soon enterprising people started breeding cobras. In the beginning, they killed cobras and won the award. And then after that sometime, they started breeding cobras. When the government came to know that they are breeding cobras, it scrapped the reward program. And when it scrapped the reward program, the cobra breeders, what did they do? They released the excess inventory, which was worthless now, setting all the snakes free. So ultimately, the number of cobras was much higher after the scheme than before the scheme. This is cobra effect. Cobra effect means that the unintended adverse consequences of well-intentioned solutions which make the problem worse than ever before. Though the historical evidence for this incident is limited, however, there are numerous such instances from all over the world reported regularly. Let me share a couple. In Afghanistan, an aid program decided to offer a financial incentive to opium poppy farmers to switch to other crops. Guess what happened? More farmers than ever started growing opium poppy to entitle for the switching incentive. The UN, a few years ago, came up with a scheme to reduce polluting greenhouse gases. And what was the scheme? The UN would give a financial reward through carbon credits, and a company can earn carbon credits by destroying these polluting gases. Guess what happened? So, exactly, this audience is learning very fast. After all, it is the descendants of those cobra breeders. So, you are right. You're right. The company started making more and more of these polluting gases to destroy them and claim the rewards. Millions of dollars they made like that. Moreover, the intermediate products which were made in the manufacture of these polluting gases, they also rose. They were also polluting, but they were not destroyed because there was no reward associated with it. If you were to look at trace a common fault of all these schemes, perhaps it would be that these were designed by people who had very limited understanding about human nature. And just as in designing incentives, in working out reform through sanctions also, this limited understanding can be catastrophic. Let me share an example. In 193 AD, Pertinax, the well-meaning emperor, Roman emperor, succeeded Commodus and inherited his army. Soon after, he mandated that all his soldiers should live honest and Spartan lives. These soldiers were used to living licentiously under Commodus. They hated Pertinax for withdrawing their privileges. And very soon they overthrew him, assassinated him. Moreover, they even auctioned the post of the emperor then. They auctioned the post of the emperor, taking things to a new low. Though the cobra effect in the beginning referred to unintended adverse consequences of public policy, but today its meaning has become much wider, because such bloomers, such mistakes are as common in the private sector and the non-government sector. So a leader must realize that the world is full of guile and aggression, and he should shrewdly comprehend how the unscrupulous and deviant man thinks and makes his moves, and devise a strategic entry past his defenses. Being shrewd should not be seen as ugly and manipulative. In fact, the holiest of men have been the shrewdest, if not for themselves, for their friends. And the learned have long known that the discovery of deceit is the true nourishment for a thoughtful mind and the true delight of a virtuous soul. So shrewdness is unapologetically necessary in successful navigation in leadership. What about deception? Let us recall how Abraham Lincoln, who was known for his sense of fair play and justice, how he steered the amendment abolishing slavery through the US Parliament. He knew that this amendment will be fiercely opposed by the rival camp, which was more numerous. Even after intense lobbying, when he realized that the bill is going to fail for two votes, he instructed his colleagues that the bill must be procured. The votes should be procured. Those two votes should be procured. He instructed them very clearly and emphatically. The votes were procured. The epoch-making bill was passed. Lincoln was surely guilty. He had done a misconduct which was grave and clear. However, the outcome it generated was grand and noble, and made this misdeed admirable. So, many a time, for breakthrough results against entrenched interests, the leader needs deception. If shrewdness and deception are so vital to leadership, what about virtue? Is virtue redundant? No, not at all. Virtue generates goodwill, and goodwill is the lifeline of leadership. Having said that, I must also say that a leader who depends solely on virtue cannot overcome evil, because sole dependence on virtue makes him too innocuous and too predictable to inspire awe, to demonstrate strength, or to win. And the leader, the virtuous leader who loses, is the worst advertisement for goodness. Because by, through his own dismal and defeated example, he turns other people away from goodness. So to sum up metaphorically for easy recall, the great leader to prevail must have the dove, the fox, and the snake in him. The dove to signal harmony and peace to followers and allies. The fox to peer deep into the cunning human mind and avoid traps and tripwires. And the snake to establish awe and sting where necessary. Once the leader realizes this, that shrewdness and deception go hand in hand with virtue, and he can blend these in him, then he is ready to swim with the sharks without losing his sovereignty and without becoming like them, and stay capable of bringing about change for the larger good when he spots his chance. Thank you very much.